Look up at the bronze figures in front of you. You know how you always see comedy and tragedy masks? This is sort of the statue version of that.
On the left is Touchstone, the court jester or clown from the play As You Like It. On the right is Hamlet from the heaviest play Shakespeare wrote. Absolutely, they represent comedy in the person of Touchstone and tragedy in the person of Hamlet.
I'm Damon Benetti. I'm a professional actor and director here in Philadelphia and the co-founder of Philadelphia Artist Collective, which is a company dedicated to classic theater that's rarely produced.
My name is Phil Wagner. I'm a past dean of a group called the Shakespeare Society of Philadelphia, following my father, who was a member before me. And ever since October of 1852, our group has been gathering together for a quick cocktail, a meal together, and then reading Shakespeare plays around the table. Be sure to walk around to the back and have a look at the names of the statue's sponsors, including, of course, the correctly spelled Shakespeare Society of Philadelphia. We spell Shakespeare in the group S-H-A-K-S-P-E-R-E.
On the front of the statue is Shakespeare's famous soliloquy, which is "All the World's a Stage." My name is Sarah Goronczyk, and I am the producing artistic director at Philadelphia Theater Company.
All the world's a stage, and all the men and women merely players.
And that is just the first line or two that leads into one of the most famous speeches that Shakespeare's written, which is "The Seven Ages of Man."
They have their exits and their entrances, and one man in his time plays many parts, his acts being seven ages.
This passage takes us on the progression from birth and infancy through to death.
At first, the infant, mewling and puking in the nurse's arms.
Then the wine. And the words that he evokes to describe all of us in youth or middle age or in courtship or finally at the end near death are perfectly chosen, and therefore very moving.
The memorial was proposed at the meeting of another long-standing Philadelphia society, the Sons of St. George, in 1891.
To become a member of that group, men had to be direct descendants of England, just like Shakespeare himself.
Men from the society wanted this great Englishman to be honored and started a campaign to commission this statue.
Philadelphia plays a very important role in the context of Shakespeare in America. Macbeth and Hamlet were first produced here in Philadelphia. Two gentlemen named Bjorn and Maiden issued the first edition of Shakespeare in 1795 here. And we're known for one of the great, great names, Horace Howard Furness, America's greatest Shakespearean scholar.
The statue was created by Alexander Sterling Calder and dedicated in 1928.
When you have a final look at the inscription on this statue, you'll reflect on the fact that indeed, all the world is a stage and all of us are merely players in our own lives and others' lives. And so these lines are a most fitting memorial to Shakespeare, his work, and his tremendous enduring significance in our world today.